वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन इन रावल कॉन्वेंट डिजिटल क्लासेस। वी आर हेयर विद द टॉपिक द राइज ऑफ नेशनलिज्म इन यूरोप। नेशन स्टेट, नेशन स्टेट वाज वन इन विच द मेजॉरिटी ऑफ इट्स सिटीजन्स एंड नॉट ओनली इट्स रूलर्स केम टू डेवलप अ सेंस ऑफ कॉमन आइडेंटिटी। फ्रेडरिक सरियू, अ फ्रेंच आर्टिस्ट, विजुअलाइज्ड हिज ड्रीम ऑफ अ वर्ल्ड मेड अप ऑफ डेमोक्रेटिक एंड सोशल रिपब्लिक्स एंड प्रेजेंटेड इट टू द वर्ल्ड एंड प्रोमोटेड द स्पिरिट ऑफ नेशनलिज्म। द फर्स्ट क्लियर एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ नेशनलिज्म came with the French Revolution in 1789 in France. It proclaimed that it was the people who would henceforth constitute the nation and shape its destiny. The political and constitutional changes came to be seen, for example, like transfer of sovereignty from the monarch to French citizens, a sense of collective identity amongst the French people was created through various measures and practices. Napoleon incorporated revolution principles in order to make the whole system more rational and efficient. The Civil Code of 1804, usually known as the Napoleonic Code, was introduced. Simplification of administrative divisions, improvement in transport and communication system, removal of guild restrictions, standardization of weights and measures, and introduction of common currency were the major changes in the system. The right to property was also secure. Making of nationalism in Europe. Eastern and Central Europe were under autocratic monarchies within the territories of which lived diverse people. Various differences didn't easily promote a sense of political unity. And political utility. The aristocracy and the new middle class made many efforts. Nationalism and the idea of nation state were achieved. Industrialization began in France and parts of the German states during the 19th century. The new social groups came into being, a working class population and middle classes. Liberal nationalism. The ideology of liberalism emerged, which ended the state interference in the economic life of society. Freedom of markets was achieved and state imposed restrictions on the movement of goods and capital were abolished. Napoleon's administrative measures were altered. In 1815, Britain, Russia, Prussia and Austria collectively defeated Napoleon and to make a settlement, the Treaty of Vienna. It was signed in Vienna in 1815. According to the provisions of this treaty, the Bourbon dynasty was restored to power. France lost the territories it had annexed under Napoleon. A series of states were set up on the boundaries of France to prevent French expansion in future. Belgium was set up in the north and Geneva was added to Piedmont in the south. Prussia was given important new territories on its western frontiers. while Austria was given control of northern Italy. Russia was given part of Poland, while Prussia was given a portion of Saxony. Revolutionaries during the year following 1815, the fear of repression drove many liberal nationalists underground. Secret societies sprang up in many European states to train revolutionaries and spread their ideas. Italian revolutionary Giuseppe Mazzini became a member of the secret society of the Carbonari. He founded two more underground societies, Young Italy in Marseilles and Young Europe in Bern. The period between 1830 to 1848 is symbolized with the age of revolutionaries. The first upheaval took place in France in July 1830. The Bourbon kings were now overthrown by liberal revolutionaries. Louis Philippe was made a constitutional monarch. Belgium got separated from the United Kingdom of the Netherlands. Greek War of Independence started in 1821. Finally, the Treaty of Constantinople of 1832 recognized Greece as an independent nation. Culture played a vital role in creating the idea of the nation through art, poetry, stories, and music. It helped to express and arouse nationalist feeling among the people. Language too played a major role in developing nationalist sentiments. It was all about this topic in this video. Remaining parts we will discuss in next video. Thank you and stay safe.